Some people wish, some people dance, some never take a chance, some people steal just for the thrill, and some drink to get there.
I was a boat stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the shelf, no wind in the sails, going nowhere with no one but me. I was one in 100 billion, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out for me. But I came to life when I first kissed you. Best me had these arms around you. You make me better than I was before. Thank God I'm yours.
Face me.
Yeah.
Okay. You can hold hands. I'll hold this hand if you want. It works. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. You have to stand. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and before His church to witness the union of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This is an honorable estate instituted and blessed by God in paradise before humanity's fall into sin. In marriage, we see a picture of the communion between Christ and His bride, the church. Our Lord blessed and honored marriage with His presence and first miracle at Cana in Galilee. This estate is also commended to us by the Apostle Paul as good and honorable. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for the mutual companionship, help, and support that each person ought to receive from each other in prosperity and adversity. Marriage was also ordained so that man and woman may find delight in one another. Therefore, all persons who marry shall take a spouse in holiness and honor, not in the passion of lust, for God has not called us to impurity, but holiness. God also established marriage for the procreation of children, who are to be brought up in the fear and instruction of the Lord, so that they may offer Him their praise. For these reasons, God has established the holy estate that Logan and Alyssa wish to enter. They desire our prayers as they begin their marriage in the Lord's name and with His blessing. Our first reading is from Genesis chapter 2. The Lord God formed the man of dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him." So out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock and to the birds of the heavens and to every beast of the field, but for Adam there was not found a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Our second reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. "If I speak in tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, we prophesy in part, but when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love." Our last reading is from John chapter 2. "On the third day there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, 'They have no wine.' And Jesus said to her, 'Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come.' His mother said to the servants, 'Do whatever he tells you.' Now there were 6 stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, 'Fill the jars with water.' And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, 'Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast.' So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted the water, now become wine, and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, 'Everyone serves the good wine first, and when the people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now.' This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him." Logan and Alyssa, grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. You made it. All right, we're here, and you're not, you know, locking your knees too much, right?
I'm trying not to pass out.
That's right. That's a good plan. Yeah. Good plan. After all of the plans, the stress, the details, even through the light rain, you're here. And we come to, hopefully, the fun part, right? It's been an adventure. Adventure is one of those words we use to nicely say it's been crazy or busy or stressful or all those things, right? Yeah. But we've been on, and you've been on this adventure together. And really for a number of years, right? Together in high school, the adventure has led you together at Tech, through gaming and... There you go, thank you. Through gaming and grocery shopping and, well, really this adventure really isn't ending either, right? You've got just a couple more months in graduation, then military and Air Force stuff, and who knows where that adventure goes after that, right? An adventure. But what makes the adventure worth it and maybe fuels you through it is that you're doing it together. And really, that's what marriage is all about, being together. That's why God designed it, right? We read that or heard that just a second ago in Genesis chapter 2. God designed marriage for a man and woman to be together. And in John chapter 2, Jesus blesses marriage. Jesus blesses that couple there and then shows us for now, for today even, God's blessing on marriage. So some of the question maybe, probably not what you're pondering right now, but maybe before and probably in the years to come is how do you do this marriage thing well, right? Well, that's kind of what our second reading is all about. The one that talked about love. It's maybe more familiar from some of the verses and places in the Bible, especially around wedding time, right? That's a little familiar to us. And it's a great way and one to have as a part of this because it tells us and reminds us that love is that secret sauce that really makes us all work, right? But it's not our love, right? It's not worldly love. It's God's love. It's not the love that we see maybe on social media or around, but it's unconditional love. Now, first, this love has to come from God to you. And well, you've been together long enough that, Alyssa, you know, he's not perfect, right? Yeah. And Logan, even though you probably don't want to admit this, in front of her at least, she's not perfect either, right?
Sure.
And we're trying to make this, you know, the perfect day, right? And even through the rain and a little cold, y'all are probably fine. But even in all this, we know that, you know, life isn't perfect. And we aren't perfect. But that's what this love is all about. Because first, it's love from God to us. We aren't perfect. We are sinful. We do things wrong, even though we have great intentions. You know, we have broken our relationship with God. And there's nothing, actually, that we can do about that. But that's what's so beautiful about love, God's love, this unconditional love that Paul talks about in 1 Corinthians 13, is because it's the love that we have in Jesus, the love that brought him to come to this world to live perfectly, actually for us, to die and to rise, to show his love for us. And really to make us whole. And it's that love that sets you guys right with the Lord, and that's the love that empowers you to love and care for each other, even on the days when you don't want to, right? Even when he keeps doing that thing that you really hate, or when she keeps nagging you about, you know, fill in the blank. But, of course, she'd never do that.
Right.
All that kind of stuff, right? It's God's love that will continue to sustain and support your marriage forever, today as you begin, and for the many, many years to come. Love that is patient and kind, right? Love that doesn't rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love that bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love is what keeps us together. First, God's love to us, And then we share that love to one another. May God always be with you in these adventures of life today and always, and may he bring you and keep you together with his love. Amen. All right, now I'll invite you to face each other. And Logan, I will address you first, and you're going to answer the question to her, okay?
Okay.
But I'll give you the answer, don't worry. Logan, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holiest state of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you nourish and cherish her as Christ loved his body, the church, giving himself up for her? Will you love, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to her alone? So long as you both shall live, then say, I do.
I do.
Do you, Alyssa, take this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holiest state of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you submit to him as Christ submits to the church, as the church submits to Christ? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to him alone, so long as you both shall live? Then say, I do.
I do.
Logan, repeat after me. I, Logan.
I, Logan.
Take you, Alyssa.
Take you, Alyssa.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
Your turn. Repeat after me. I, Alyssa.
I, Alyssa.
Take you, Logan.
Take you, Logan.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
Rings. I should have warned you, sorry. One more. All right. Awesome.
You get it.
He got it, yeah. They're all here. We pray. Almighty Father, you have graciously created all things to serve us for our good. Send your blessing upon this couple who shall wear these rings as a constant reminder of their marital fidelity. Grant that by your mercy they may live gladly and faithfully in this holy estate. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. All right, you first. Take this one, put your left hand for him. Thank you. Repeat after me. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge and sign.
As a pledge and sign.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
All right, now do this one. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, you can put them on.
You can slide.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to let
Repeat after me. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge and sign.
As a pledge and sign.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
That's a pretty dope ring.
All right, now you can face me. Now that Logan and Alyssa have committed themselves to each other in holy matrimony, have given themselves to each other by their solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. We pray. The Almighty and gracious God abundantly grant you his favor and sanctify and bless you with the blessing given to Adam and Eve in paradise, that you may please him in both body and soul and live together in holy love until your life's end. Almighty and everlasting God, our Heavenly Father, grant that by your blessing, Logan and Alyssa may live together according to your word and promise. Strengthen them in faithfulness and love toward each other. Sustain and defend them in every trial and temptation. Help them to live in faith toward you, in the communion of your holy church, and in loving service to each other, that they may ever enjoy your heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Now it is my honor at this time to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Logan Baldwin. You may kiss the bride.
Every morning when you come downstairs, here's a mess, but I don't care. No makeup on, shining so bright. My old sweatshirt never fits so right. Dancing around to the radio, humming the words that you don't know, 'cause I'm finding an angel off my list.